Children, we have studied about hardware, all the components of the computer that we can touch and see are called hardware. So let us see what is a software. We all know that the computer components are divided into hardware and software. So we know what is a hardware. Now let us see what is a software. Software is a set of instructions and data that makes hardware functional to complete the desired task. So what is a software? Softwares are the set of instructions and data that makes the hardware functional, that makes the hardware to function. So if there is no software, hardware is of no use. Hardware needs to be operated by a set of instructions. That instructions are called software. It is that component of a computer system which we cannot touch and view physically. It comprises of the instructions and data to be processed using the computer hardware. So all the applications that we use in our computer are examples of softwares, like the operating system, like our Windows, Linux, then web browsers, then RecycleWin, applications like PowerPoint, Excel, games, all these comes under software. So what is the need of a software? The sole purpose of a software is to make computer hardware useful and operational. So, for the working of a computer hardware, we need a software. A software knows how to make different hardware components of a computer work and communicate with each other as well as with the end user. So the computer software helps the hardware to communicate with the end user. Like, we cannot talk to or instruct the hardware of a computer directly. So software acts as an interface between human user and the hardware. So like, we cannot tell the printer to print directly, but we have to open the software where we have to provide the instructions to print. Then that software will provide the instruction to the printer and the printer will perform its function. So the software acts as an interface between the user and the hardware. Now, depending on the mode of interaction with the hardware and the functions to be performed, software can be broadly classified into three categories. They are system software, programming tools, application software. So, computer software can be classified into system software, application software, and programming languages. So, you can see the user can interact with the computer with the help of a software. So, softwares are of three types. They are application software, programming language tools, then the system software. System software is further divided into three types. They are system utilities, operating system, and device drivers. So, with all these softwares, the user can interact with the hardware. So, software acts as an interface between the user and the hardware. Let us see the first type of software, that is system software. The system software is the software that provides the basic functionality to operate a computer by interacting directly with its constituent hardware. A system software knows how to operate and use different hardware components of a computer. It provides services directly to the end user or to some other softwares. Examples of system softwares are operating system, system utilities, device drivers. These three are examples of system software. Without a system software, the computer will not work. So let us see what is operating system. Operating system is a type of system software. Without an operating system, the computer will not work. As the name implies, operating system is a system software that operates the computer. An operating system is the most basic system software, without which other softwares cannot work. The operating system manages other application programs and provides access and security to the users of the system. Some of the popular operating systems are Windows, Linux, Macintosh, Ubuntu, Fedora, Android, iOS, etc. Next is system utilities. Software is used for maintenance and configuration of the computer system is called system utility or utility software. Some system utilities are shipped with the operating system. For example, disk defragmentation tool, formatting utility, system restore utility, etc. Some utility tools are within that of the operating system, shipped with the operating system. When we install our operating system itself, these tools will be available. And another set of utilities are those which are not shipped with the operating system but are required to improve the performance of the system. For example, antivirus software, disk cleaner software, disk compression software. These all are installed to increase the performance of the computer system. Next is device drivers. The purpose of device driver is to ensure proper functioning of a particular device. The device driver acts as an interface between the device and the operating system. It provides required services by hiding the details of operations performed at the hardware level of the device. Just like a language translator, a device driver acts as a mediator between the operating system and the attached device. So, each day we are using different devices in our computer system, connecting different devices in our computer system. So, it is very difficult for our operating system to manage these all devices. So, it is using device drivers for different devices. To manage each device, there are device drivers. So, device driver act as a mediator between the operating system and the attached device. So, we studied about system software. System software, different examples are operating system, then system utilities, then device drivers. Our next type of software is programming tools. So we all know that all the softwares are set of instructions or programs. So programming language is the third category of computer software, which is used by the programmers to write their programs, scripts and instructions which can be executed by the computer. The other name of programming language is computer language that can be used to create some common standards. The programming language can be considered as a brick which can be used to construct computer programs and operating system. The examples of programming language are Java, C, C++, Python, Pascal. All these are programming languages. So, our computer language is of two types. They are high level language and low level language. The language that a human being can understand are called high level language. Example, Java, C, C++, Python, Pascal, .NET. All these are programming, high level programming languages. And low level languages are of two types, machine level language and assembly level language. Machine level language is a language that our computer system only can understand. It is in the form of binary numbers, that is 0 and 1. And low level language, assembly level language, is in the form of certain codes. For addition they use add, for multiplication mul. So such type of small codes are used in assembly level language. So the softwares used for programming purpose are programming softwares. Next type of software is application software. Different users need the computer system for different purpose depending upon their requirements. So a new category of software is needed to cater to different requirements of the end user. The specific software that works on top of the system software is termed as application software. These are again divided into general purpose software and customized application software. So if I want to create a Word document, I need a software which can satisfy my need, that is to type a document. For that purpose we cannot use a web browser. So we need a software to satisfy that our need. For that purpose we are using an application software. So application software is of two categories, general purpose software and customized software. So we can see what is a general purpose software. The application software developed for generic application to cater to a bigger audience in general are called general purpose software. Such ready-made application software can be used by end users as per their requirements. For example, spreadsheet tool LibreOffice Calc can be used by any computer user to do calculation or to do create an account sheet. Then Adobe Photoshop, Mozilla web browser, iTunes, etc. fall in the category of general purpose software, because it is not specific to a particular user. Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Word, all these are general purpose softwares, because while development of that software, it is not aimed for a particular community, but it is aimed for a large population, or it is aimed for general users, for it is not aimed for a particular group of community. Any person can use it for their own purpose. So that type of software is called general purpose software. Next is customized software. These are custom or tailor-made application software that are developed to meet the requirements of a specific organization or an individual. They are better suited to the needs of an individual or an organization, considering that they are designed as per special requirements. Some examples of user-defined software include websites, school management software, accounting software, etc. It is similar to buying a piece of cloth with specific color and fabric and get it stitched as desired. Like the app softwares in our schools for storing the details of teachers, students, fees details. That software is customized for that particular school or a particular school. That software cannot be used in hospitals for storing the details of patients, doctors, or booking token. That hospital need a set of different kind of software. So these two are customized for a particular community. Such type of software are called customized software. A software which are customized for a particular community. So a hospital management software cannot be used in a school because it has different functionalities that can be applicable only in the hospital. But a school management software can only be used in schools because it does not have any options that can be accessed by other group of people. So these type of softwares are called customized software. So we have learned about different types of software. They are system software. In the system software, we have learned operating system, utility software, then about the device drivers, then we have learned programming tools, then application softwares in that general purpose and customized software. Now we have another set of software. They are proprietary or free and open source software. So there are two types of software. They are proprietary software or free and open source software. While development of the software itself, they give license to certain softwares. While downloading certain softwares, the softwares are provided with certain license. Based on that accessibility of the software is divided into proprietary, freeware and open source software. Proprietary software, freewares and open source software. Developers of some software allow public to freely use their software along with the source code with an aim to improve further with other apps with the others' help. Such software is known as free and open source software. A software, when we download that software, its source code is also available to us. So if a user is interested to change the source code and improve the functionalities in that software, the software grants that permission. The user can make any changes in the source code of that software and he can distribute the software to his friends or any others. For example, the source code of operating system Ubuntu is freely accessible for anyone with the required knowledge to improve or add any functionality. More examples of free and open source include Python software, then MySQL, Java, NetBeans, LibreOffice, OpenOffice, Mozilla Firefox. All these are open source software, so we can download it. The software with its source code is also available. So we can make any change in the source code and we can redistribute the source code to any others. There is no legal issues while distributing this open source software, because the users are free to edit and distribute the software. Sometimes softwares are freely available for use, but source code may not be available. Sometimes we can download softwares free of cost, that is without money. But its source code is not available. That type of software is called freeware. Examples of freeware are Skype, Adobe Reader, etc. That software we can install, but its source code is not available. Next is, when software to be used are to be purchased from the vendor who has the copyright of the software, then it is a proprietary software. The software we install in our computer system which has a copyright, that is, its source code cannot be edited, the software cannot be distributed to others, such legal issues are there with the proprietary software. Examples of proprietary software include Microsoft Windows, Tally, QuickHeal, etc. A software can be freeware or open source or proprietary software, depending upon the terms and conditions of the person or group who has developed and released that software. So based on these terms and conditions, software can be either freeware, that is, it is available free of cost. Then it can be open source, that is, its source code is available and we can make our own changes in the source code and redistribute these softwares. Or copyright protected softwares, they are called proprietary software and we cannot change the source code because its source code is not available. Source code of proprietary software is not available to us, so we cannot make any changes in the software. Even if we distribute the software, then there is a chance of legal issues. Thank you.